Birds may keep trying. Sam Litzinger, CBS News.
Have you ever thought about saying goodbye to your job? Just walking into your boss and saying, I quit. And how would you like to commute to work without ever leaving your home? Well, not long ago, a 39-year-old entrepreneur from a billionaire family spent $20 million in 3 years to find the best home-based business in North America. He researched 70 different companies, and when he found the only one that had real long-term potential, he bought it. And right now, he's looking for people to help him turn this company into his next billion-dollar success story. So if you're serious about making money from home without having to leave your home, well, grab a pen. Because I'm about to give you the address of a website where you can learn all about this unique and rare opportunity. Write this down. www.gohernext.com. Now get on your computer and go to this site now. Part-time or full-time, your income is based totally on your performance. Interested? GoHereNext.com and say goodbye to your boss tomorrow. GoHereNext.com.
What's the deal? We keep it real. We unleash, y'all know what it is. We unleash, you gon' get all the biz. We unleash, we gon' show off your skills for real. So tune in for advice and news every Saturday night if you like the truth. We stand up for your rights and rules. Saturdays at 5, we'll fight for you. Skinny and GQ for LGBTQ. We keep it simple, but keep it equal. Skinny and GQ for LGBTQ. We keep it simple, but keep it equal. Blood or what?
My neck and my back lick my ow. This is the K, the double N, the teacher of the R's. I'm sitting here with Attorney Rob. I just scared the hell out of him with G to the Q. And we're in the house today. We're fired up. Hello, somebody.
Yes. We in the house.
So I will act presidential from here on out.
Rob totally just got through doing Dan Aykroyd.
He did not say Dan Aykroyd.
Who did you get?
Will Ferrell. I'm not used to speaking in microphones, so I'm not sure where to put my face or my hands. And then you tell me it's a radio show, and I come in, you're taping it, and then you're putting it on my Facebook page where my mother could watch it. So I would have worn a nicer shirt. I don't know. I'm happy to be here, though. Thank you all very much for inviting me onto the show.
See, you fit right in.
Welcome.
It's no problem. Well, let me do my little introduction. What's going on, radio land and social media land and everybody in the sound of my voice? It's 5 o'clock Saturday, and you know what time it is. It's the Unleashed Voice radio show, broadcasting live on KWAM 990 and FM 107.9, the new voice. Talk radio for Memphis, and we're in this thing. This is Davian and Gwen Clemens, and we got Attorney Rob in the house with us, and we got a great radio show. We're going to do three things while you listen to this radio show. We're going to educate, we're going to empower you, and we're going to enrich you with some information, and we hope that at the end of our broadcast, you will have a great takeaway. But right now, it's a whole lot of things going on in our world, and we're going to roll over to Davian. What's on your mind?
Amberosa is not a low life.
Amberosa.
Whatever her name is, she's not a low life.
She not.
Well, I don't know. That's what 45 called her. No, that's what 46 minus 1 called her. No, I want to talk about something else. I want to talk about suicide for 1 second.
Okay.
I just had another associate to commit suicide.
What?
And so, sorry to hear that. Yeah, so he was LGBT. And so these are facts about individuals who identify as LGBT. So in the LGBT community, suicide is the second leading cause of death amongst young people between the ages 10 to 24. So remember, these words you say to people and the discrimination and the things you do, they hurt. Words do hurt. And so overall, for our statistics, suicide is like the 10th leading cause of death in the U.S. for all ages. So mental health is real. We have a lot of work to do. And this is like the fourth person that I have known in the last 2 months who commit suicide. It was a young brother. I'm not calling out names. But check on people. With people who have mental issues, refer them to the proper counseling. Intervene. Say something. Do not sit back and ignore the warning signs or the red flags of individuals who are suffering from depression and rejection of their families and all the above. So just look out for individuals, care for each other, because people are killing themselves because of pressure. The young man who stole the airplane in, was it Seattle?
Yeah.
And he was talking on to the people over the radio, and he was just saying he's just a loose cannon, and he doesn't care, and he crashed the plane and killed himself. And so suicide is real, so just look out for people and pray for people and just try to help. So that's what's on my mind today, that suicide piece, and I guess that'll segue us to our interview.
Well, thanks for dropping that on us.
I know.
That's a light way
right,
to start.
Right, yeah. right. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
And so, wow, that's heartbreaking to hear.
Yeah.
And it's a topic that we won't shy away from. We're going to make sure that we do our due diligence to get a mental health professional on the radio show. So if there's any mental health professionals out there that would like to be our guest to come on and talk about the signs of suicide, what we can do, Memphis Crisis Center, if somebody listening, we need you guys to connect with us so we can get a show dedicated to suicide prevention. We need to get a show dedicated to that.
Absolutely.
Yeah. What you think about that? I think that'd be great.
That's a very good idea.
Yeah. So listen, we got a great radio show lined up for you all, and it's an interesting topic, and I'm so excited that we receive a confirmation to interview this great law firm that's doing an awesome event in Memphis. But I'm going to let our guest come on in and introduce himself before we take our first commercial break. Come on in.
Thank you so much. My name is Rob Ratton. I'm a native born Memphian. I left for a while and then somehow Memphis pulled me back in. I've been back for about 10 years now. I've been practicing employment law for about 5 or so years. And our firm recently, we've started to try to do a new type of continuing legal education and human resources training. We do a lot of that as employment lawyers. We're obviously out all the time trying to train clients on how to behave properly, how to follow the law. But the problem is most of these trainings are just me up there talking about other folks' lives and saying how you need to act. So we had the idea that we should start bringing in storytellers, people that are talented, brilliant storytellers that come say what life is like from their perspective. So it's kind of based on the principle, good intentions are necessary to create a good workforce, but good intentions aren't enough to keep you from getting sued. So you got to have both.
Right.
You got to have both. You got to have the right mindset. You got to have the right intentions, but you got to also understand where the pitfalls are.
Yes.
So we think if we combine storytelling and if we combine legal training, then we really are offering our clients the best chance at creating an inclusive workplace, creating a workplace where everyone can thrive. And we're having an event coming up August 16th at High Cotton Brewery, which has beer, as breweries tend to have. We will be serving that beer, and we'll have food. And we're going to hear from the amazing Barbara Hope telling about her life as a transgender woman and her experiences. And she's remarkable. She is absolutely an unbelievable storyteller. She's an unbelievable person, and I think everyone's going to get a lot out of it.
Well, we were downstairs and just talking about we'll talk for like 2 minutes and take our first break.
Okay.
So we were just talking about how important it is for individuals to, such as yourself, being a heterosexual man, to be vocal about this topic and being inclusive, being accepting, welcoming, and just being a spokesperson, not a spokesperson, but an ally to the community to help the individuals such as Barbara tell their stories, because nobody can tell your story better than you. Amen. And so you were talking downstairs and you had some great points on how it's important for you to be vocal and doing what you're doing to push this storytelling event on August 16th.
Well, I think a lot of it, and after the break, we can talk more about the specifics of what turned me onto this idea, but hearing Barbara and other storytellers speak helped me realize my own limitations. Yeah. I try my best to understand life from as many perspectives as possible, but it's hard.
Yeah.
And when you take, it's like Mark Twain talked about travel is fatal to prejudice.
Yeah.
Well, I think storytelling is kind of like that traveling. You know, it allows people, it's fatal to prejudice. Once you hear someone's story and you're like, oh my God, I never thought about that. I never saw it from that perspective, but I do now. And I respect the dignity of that person. I respect their right to determine who they are and express who they are.
Mm-hmm.
It changes the way you act, and it changes the way you believe. And so that's, to me, it's an acknowledgement that, I was born a a chubby white dude in Memphis, Tennessee. And there, which is, I've had some great experiences in life. I've gotten to meet a lot of fascinating people, but I have to have other people come in and tell me, this is what we want out of life. Yep. And I want you to try to help me get there. Yep. And respect that.
Mm, that's interesting. So just out of curiosity, was that your first time having a interaction or conversation with a transgender person?
No, actually my freshman year or sophomore year of college, we had a good friend who was transgender, who transitioned from male to female, and and I got to kind of observe that process. But we have several friends in the LGBT community, but it was the first time I just sat down and really just kind of heard someone tell their story.
Wow.
You know, like it's hard in everyday life to come up to someone you don't know that well and be like, hey, tell me your story.
Yeah.
Let me hear your genesis, your story about how you became who you are. I mean, that's just it. You know, we go out and have beers, but I never sat down with Alana and said, tell me how everything came about.
Yeah.
You know, and but with when you have a when you're a storytelling event, you have that advantage,
right,
of just being able to sit back and listen without any. You don't have anything invested in it. You
right.
don't have any need for judgment.
Right.
You don't. It doesn't have. If you disagree with everything they say and you think they're awful, so what?
I know.
You know,
right.
it doesn't affect you.
Right.
But if
right.
but if you would internalize it and listen to it, you can really learn a lot. And that's what happened to me. It's like I was telling someone this story, and they're like, "So it woke you up?" And I'd like never. I'd always heard that expression, but I'd never. Really thought about it, but I was
right.
like, it did. It absolutely, it woke something inside of me that was more than just an academic appreciation for equality.
Right.
It was a genuine, I'm like, Barbara is a wonderful human being who deserves to live her life in the way she chooses. And I can, hopefully we can help express that.
Well, we're going to talk more about the importance of storytelling and about this great law firm, Fisher Phillips. And so, Spinderella just picked a song. This is the live show, KWAM 900 Talk Radio, the new 107.9. We'll be right back after this pause for the call.
Chubby waist, thick legs, in shape, rump shaking both ways, make you do a double take.
Choices is a nonprofit sexual health clinic in Midtown Memphis. We accept 10 care and offer patient assistance to help pay for needed services. Choices is proud to provide comprehensive reproductive health services in an LGBTQ affirming environment. We offer a wide range of services such as general wellness, fertility assistance, STI testing and treatment, reproductive health services for people living with HIV, including PrEP and PEP, birth control, Gardasil vaccinations, abortion services, miscarriage management, and services for trans and gender nonconforming people, including hormone replacement therapy. Everybody needs choices.
Dear HIV,
I may have gotten you,
but you will never, ever get the best of me.
I take charge of my health.
I take my HIV meds every day.
I don't just live with you. I live well with you.
HIV treatment works.
Get in care.
Stay in care.
Live well.
Let's talk about sex, baby.
In Memphis, condoms are free from Planned Parenthood and their friends all over town.
Nothing sexier than free. So check out freecondomsmemphis.org and get some.
Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex.
Want to talk about sex? Talk about condoms at freecondomsmemphis.org. Get some before you get some. freecondomsmemphis.org.
Let's talk about sex, baby.
Go get tested for HIV/AIDS because HIV/AIDS has become the third leading cause of death among African Americans between the ages of 25 and 34. Even more surprising is the fact that this disease has become the leading cause of death for African American women between the ages of 25 and 34. The spread of HIV/AIDS is the single greatest health crisis currently confronting African Americans.
Join the Cathedral Praise Church of Memphis Incorporated each Sunday at 12:30 p.m. for our Spirit-filled worship service and each Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. for our Bible study. You do not want to miss these power-packed services. We are a church for all people, and we welcome you as we transition.